Hello, good evening. Great first. Jamie said I should greet all of you. May God will continue to bless you all. I said he's very grateful. He was praying for me. He was so happy to bring the immigration officer and the police officer to come and claim. He's so happy. He was so happy. He was just smiling. Say God. So I saw these two girls. One of them is walking inside. So they are trying to, they were running from me, they are hiding from me. So one of them knocking, the one that one of them have mine, the other one came from Abuja. He said, are you Mama K? I said, who are you, please? I said, I said, are you K first? She was smiling. I said, you are what? You are who? I said, yes, I'm Mama K. I said, you are who? She now said, yes. So when Yemi came, one of them was trying to help to push one of the trolley. So and I asked, I said, who are you again? I said, why are you this girl? Then one of them was trying to come Yemi, saying, trying to explain what happened, what Kosi is regretting now. Then I went to go and meet her. I said, will you fucking leave Yemi alone? In front of Yemi. I said, will you fucking leave this boy alone? Are you fucking mad? Are you people crazy? I said, Yemi, don't listen to these hypocrites. Yemi was smiling, was just smiling. Then Anna moved her from in front of Yemi. They started following us. They want to follow us to the diplomatic park. I said, you can't follow us to the diplomatic park. You ain't just end. I not send those police to stop them, not to follow us inside. They were saying, they just want to, okay, let them just hug Yemi. I said, Yemi don't ready. He's not even ready to hug you. Look at the Yemi. He's ready to. He has already hugged people. You have snapped with him. What again do you want? I said, Yemi, don't listen to these people. They are still using Yoruba to talk to you.
Yemi, and it's not like we're using Igbo accent to pronounce Yemi as Yemi. So it's Koyemi. And people are like, it's Blue Ava. Blue really loves this boy. I know as we're trying to bring South African girls into Nigeria to be our sister-in-laws now. What future do you see with Blue Ava?
The future is bright with everyone. The future is bright. The future is bright.
God will forgive you, Yemi. But okay, the future is bright with everyone. Guys, you said the future is bright with Blue Ava.
Eh? What? You said that, not me.
Allow me to behave like a blogger now.
You said, please.
You know, when they put all those their titles, they'll say, Yemi says, the future is bright with Blue Ava. Then people come inside and see the real thing.
Please.
Okay. So let us leave you and girls alone. Let's leave you and girls alone.
Appreciate it. I would appreciate it.
I might come back to you. Don't be too sure. So the next question is, how do you feel about Miracle right now?
How I feel about Miracle right now, I don't feel any way towards Miracle. I just felt like,
hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Every Day with Idara Iyang. If you've not yet subscribed, this is the right time to do so. Please click on that subscribe button and turn on the notification for more videos for me. Thank you. Okay guys, there's a lot of gist surrounding Yemi as regards his relationship with Kosi and Blue Ava and Omo. Even if he's trying not to dish out a lot of gist about them, a lot of gist is just slipping out of his mouth, okay? So let me just start from the beginning. All right, so if you listen to the very first voice note, you'll hear when Yemi came back from South Africa, a lady known as, I think, Mama K, if I got the name right, came to the airport to assist him with clearance. Not how airport is, if any of you have traveled out of Nigeria, there's airport wahala, you know? So she came to my life, deal with it. So two ladies, according to her, approached Yemi. Obviously these are groupies, if you would know what groupies are. Groupies are like ladies that are so in love with a male or maybe even female, anyone, but they're in love with this famous icon, famous person. The person has to be famous, and Yemi to an extent is famous. So obviously they are attracted to him, and that was why they were trying to farm him. Also, they're trying to feed him with information about Kosi, according to her, like, oh, Kosi did this, Kosi did that. But Mama K instructed them to like leave him alone, and Yemi to like stay away from them. Oh God, I don't even know why I'm talking about this, really, because to me, both of them are like this. Yemi is a grown-up man. Yes, it was a big deal that you came to the airport to help him to clear the airport wahala, because it can be very stressful. But afterwards, you don't need, because her voice was sounding very authoritative, and this is a man. You don't need to be instructing him and instructing them and trying to be his bodyguard. I like his reaction. According to her, he was smiling and just in one side, just smiling. Which, if I was in Yemi's shoes, I would do the same thing, because she actually did do a good thing for me, which is helping me to clear myself in the airport. But after that, don't get involved. You don't need to get involved. That's my own opinion, though, but I know you fans are going to come after me. You don't need to get. This is a grown ass man. Like, are you freaking kidding me? Yeah. Anyways, if you want to know the summary of the story, you can go back to the beginning and yeah, it. I don't even feel like talking about it, to be honest. I just maybe one or two of you fans might want to be interested in it, and that's why I played it. Anyways. Let's move on. So, Yemi did other interviews. One of them is the one with this lady that you just listened to. I like the way he was trying to be political in his answers, but still, he still said something. As far as he said something, we carry it like that. You know, she asked him that, what future do you see with Blue Ava? And she was like, the future is, he was like, the future is bright with everybody. And she was like, the future is bright with Blue Ava. You heard it, guys. And it sounds like, of course, you saying the future is bright with Blue Ava is different from you saying the future is bright with everybody. It just reads different meaning. All right. So he was not having it, and he basically begged to not be thrown under the bus. Okay. So, guys, I'm pretty sure he's trying to stay out of fans wahala, is trying to be peaceful, and he's just trying to build his brand, do his business. Anyways, he also did another interview. You know, it's funny though, but all of his questions are always around surrounding his relationship. But that was the game he played in the house, so you cannot blame the interviewers. Anyways, he was asked the same thing about Cosi, like, what do you think about Cosi? And he was like, Cosi is my friend. Then the interviewer was like, so Cosi is just a friend. And Yemi said he never said that. He said Cosi is my friend, not Cosi is just a friend. And then the interviewer was trying to be like, okay, now, like, give us more information about this question. And he was like, I am just trying to keep quiet for now and keep everything private, because since he came out of the house, he has been hearing a lot of things. So he just wants to keep everything private. All right. And also, if you've not watched this interview where he did where he was asked the question about being Kosi's bodyguard when Tabang and Kosi were in the bathroom, it was like he didn't see himself as being a bodyguard, because he just coincidentally was always around Kosi when Kosi was talking to Tabang. And he just wanted to also call everybody on their BS, because if you are trying to play, he was like looking for an opportunity to go back to the type of guy he was, but he wanted a good reason. He didn't just want to leave when there is no reason to leave. So that was why he was trying to call Kosi out on her BS with Tabang, but he didn't see himself as being a bodyguard. Yeah, I get it. I get it. I think Yemi just wanted a good, and that's actually tallies with what Kosi said. Kosi said to Miracle that she feels bad for stressing Yemi out with Tabang, because Tabang is just a baby. So that means she was doing it intentionally. So I believe what Yemi said. He said coincidentally he's always around when Kosi is doing something with Tabang. So that means Kosi will time herself, make sure Yemi is somewhere around, and then start flirting with Tabang. It rhymes well, and I believe what Yemi said. Yeah. And guess what? I don't know how true this is, because I don't have any video about it, but they said that shippers came, that Yemi and Kosi shippers came to give Yemi gifts, and Yemi rejected the shippers' gifts. If this is not true, I don't know what else to say. I don't know what to say about it, but if this is true, maybe they did not tell him how much the shippers' gift was. Like, maybe the gift is not much. Maybe it's just 30 B and Do you know what they used to give shippers in Nigeria for people in Nigeria? You'll be hearing things like 5 million and 10 million. Ah, I want to see the video or actually hear an actual amount, like the actual thing that they gave him. I want to hear Yemi rejected 10 million from shippers, Kosi and Yemi shippers. Then I'll be able to, you know, qualify it, because recently, I think the only person that has received big gifts is Olivia. Olivia received, okay, allegedly, Olivia allegedly received 2 million naira from her fans. She's the only one that has gotten a big amount. The remaining people have been getting teddy bear, gift here and there, but nothing big, you know. And I'm not trying to put each housemate against each other. I'm just saying, I am trying to figure out what kind of gifts they gave Yemi. I mean, there's some gifts that when they give you, it's not be hard for you to reject. Yeah. I want to hear, okay, you rejected 27 million. You rejected 20 million. We'll be like, okay, Yemi, you try. Anyways, let's move on from that. Like I said, Olivia was gifted 2 million, and congratulations to her, if it is true. You see, I use the word allegedly because, and I don't want to say anything. I'm not saying fans did not give her, but we've seen things. It's all I can say. All right. So if it is true, congratulations to her. If it's not true, well, more grease to your hustling elbow, because it does work. If people outside are perceiving you to be famous and beloved by fans, you would get ambassador deals, because the businesses that want to sign you as an ambassador would think that you have fans that would buy any product that you advertise. So it's good. I get it, if that's the method you want to use, you know, to get your business rolling. Anyways, moving on, I will just talk about Ifeanyi and Miracle. Ifeanyi and Miracle seem to be going on strong in their relationship. I mean, from kissing, Ifeanyi serenaded Miracle, telling him sweet words, just making his head swell, like just making him feel good. She basically was playing the guitar and just serenading Miracle, and I'm like, oh my god, how will Luke feel? She's not even mentioned Luke again. Is she just playing the game, or is she madly, crazily in love with Miracle? Comment below and let me know what you think about that. And also comment below and let me know what you think about Yemi rejecting the gifts from fans, if it is true. Also comment below and let me know what you think about Olivia's gifts. Otostela, congratulations. Let's not stir the water too much, okay? And also comment below and let me know what you think about the various interviews that Yemi had with various interviewers talking about Blue Ava and Kosi. I'll be at the comment section, and I'll be sure to reply your comments as soon as possible. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!